Welcome to Tiger Woodlands Golf School. Today we're going to be teaching about golf. The first thing you need to learn about golf is getting buff. So we're going to do a couple simple exercises to make you capable of hitting the long ball. Alright, so here we go. First thing we're going to do is some calisthenics. You got to stretch up high and you come down. Oh, and you go down. Oh. But more importantly, you got to work on those arms. You see, you got to get them real buff like mine. Once your arms are big and buff, then you're ready to play the game of golf. So here we go. First thing, you need to have a golf club. Right here, I have my trusty, oh, whatever it is. Doesn't really matter in the game of golf as long as you got something to hit your ball. Now let's see what we're going to be playing with today. Now, in contemporary golf, they play with this thing they call the golf ball. I think it should be called more like the stupid ball, because only weenies play with it. Yeah. So today, we're going to be concentrating on more fun objects, like this tomato we have here. Now, the next important thing in golf is you got to have the right and proper stance. So what you want to do is get your legs about, well, I don't know, about yay distance apart. And then you got to make sure to get the rump. Just get it about, I don't know, I'd say a 90-degree angle. And then sometimes the club is a little too long for you when you do this. So all you gotta do is just choke up a little bit and you're ready to play. So here we go on our first shot on this tomato. Ah, yes, that was the practice swing. You see, I forgot to mention the practice swing. You gotta get a little mud on your club first before you go. So all you gotta do next is just swipe that off. And then you're ready to really hit your object. So here we go. 90 degree angle, choke up on the club, and we're, oh, well, see, this is the benefit of not playing for one of those stupid balls. As you can see here, we still have some tomato left. Did I have to go chase my ball? No, I didn't. I still got some right here. So you know what you do? We're going to line up and hit it again. Now, I'm going to show you another important stance. This one I call the crisscross. What you simply have to do is take your right foot and put it behind your left foot, and then you take your left foot and step in front of your right. See, this gives you the momentum to twist as you hit your object, giving it optimum distance. Here we go. Did you get a load of that one?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Now that's what I'm talking about. Now let's move on to our second object, the banana. Now, earlier we were using the iron. Now we're going to switch to my favorite club, which is called the driver. Now, I like to call it the hamburger on a stick, because you see here you have the hamburger and a stick. Now, another important thing of golf, see, sometimes sunglasses are doing great. They're getting the sun out of the eyes, but you need a little more protection than that. You need a hat with a rim. So you pull out your trusty cap, put it on, and there you go. Keeps all the sun out. Now, I like to go with a hat that is soft and pliable so you can put it in your back pocket and pull it out whenever you need. All right, here we go. You grab your hamburger and stick, and now on this club, you want to make sure that you grip it nice and tight. Whenever I started my career early on, often the hamburger would fly further than the banana. So you have to make sure to grip it really tight. Now, the positioning on the banana and how I like to treat it is we went over the bend and the crossover, and now we're going to take it from a kneeling stance. Now, as you can see, the style of banana that we picked out today. Important is that, you see this brown right here? That means your object is soft. And you need that to show off how far you can hit a soft object at the maximum distance. Grab your club, take a little squat, give it a pop. Oh. Oh. Oh yeah, now see, that's what I'm talking about. You can't even see the banana anymore. That's why you gotta pick out the correct one. Now, our last soft item of this week is the egg. Now, our last stance I learned from my good friend Happy Gilmore. And you start from back, I know, back behind the egg sounds kind of weird again. But see, what you're doing is you're accelerating your whole kinetic mass to one point when you reach back, maximum power exerts upon impact, total potential to your object, and it just goes flying. Now let's gonna show you how we do it at Tiger Woodlands Pro School. Out of this world, baby. Stay tuned next week whenever we move on to hard objects.